קצת.
אוקיי, בעזרת השם.
The lens crafter.
I must have gone on vacation on it. Looks like no one could make it. Okay, Bezrat Hashem, we're starting Daf Yud Aleph. Daf Yud Aleph, Amud Aleph. We're starting Daf Yud Aleph. So we said yesterday in the Mishnah that Rabbi Yehuda says, the Gemara says, the Mishnah says, sorry, that the Yehuda says, Bodkim, Or Yudalid, Bodkim, Or Yudalid, Ub Yudalid Shachrit, B'Sha'at HaBi'ur. And we said, what does the Yehuda mean when he says, Bodkim, B'Sha'at HaBi'ur? But not past that. Why does he let you Bodek past that? Why does he let you Bodek after that? Because after that, he's afraid you're going to come to eat it. Right? Like the Gemara in Pesha Ashishit, yeah, we're afraid you're going to eat it. Well, B'Sha'at HaBi'ur, B'Sha'at HaBi'ur Mistama Ashishit. Right? Says Gemara, Umi Gazar, Rabbi Yehuda, Dilma Ati, Lameichal Minei. Let's read from the second line from the bottom. והאחה בהאקה מפלגים מור סבר מקמי איסורה אין בתר איסורה לא. רבי יהודה says, before the time of the איסור, you could check. בתר איסורה, after the time of the איסור, don't check. Why? דל מעתי למייחל מיני. Maybe you'll come to eat from it. ומור סבר, and one holds that you can't do that. Why? That you can't do it... You can't check B'Sha'at HaBi'ur. But Ramban said, look, guys, we don't make a gezerah, maybe you'll come to check B'Sha'at HaBi'ur. So now the Gemara is assuming that Rabbi Yehuda doesn't let you check B'Sha'at HaBi'ur or after the Sha'at HaBi'ur because we're afraid you're going to empty them. Umi gazar Rabbi Yehuda al dema ati l'meicha mine, does Rabbi Yehuda have such a gezerah? V'hatenam, we learned, mi shekarev ha'omer, once they will makriv the omer, yotzim, they would go out, umotzim shukei Yerushalayim. So they bring the Omer on the first day of Chol HaMoed Sukkot, of Chol HaMoed Pesach. Umotziim shukei Yerushalayim, found the market of Yerushalayim, shehem mele'im kemach vekalim, that was full of flour and roasted flour, shelo b'ritzon hachamim, not according to the will of the hachamim.
What? The market was open Chol HaMoed?
Of course, they sell food.
Food is coming.
You always have to sell food. Kimati could sell food on Chol HaMoed, on Yom Tov. Right? Shelo b'ritzon hachamim, not according to the Esav HaChetzer. Right? Shelo b'ritzon hachamim, Rashi. Why shelo b'ritzon hachamim? The ika l'migzar dilma kimi aski be ati l'meichal minei. We have to be afraid, maybe while they're working with it, they might come to eat it. Rashi, Mishikareva Omer, the Rashi on the page before. Bo Bayom, on that day, Yotzim, they would go out. Umotzim Shukei Yerushalayim, they would find the markets of Yerushalayim. Meleim Kemach Vekali, full of flour and roasted flour, Mina Hadash, from the new crop. Limkor, to sell. Vekodem Yom Tov Nektaf Venethan, Venetyabesh Akali Betanur. Before Yom Tov, it was already chopped and it was ground. So you see that they were picking it before when it was Asur. Devrei Rabbi Meir. Rabbi Meir also shlo b'tzon chachamim because I'm afraid they're going to come to eat from it. Rabbi Yehuda omer, b'tzon chachamim ayu osim. Rabbi Yehuda says they used to do b'tzon chachamim. Ve'lo kagazar Rabbi Yehuda dil ma'ati l'mei chalminei. And Rabbi Yehuda didn't make a gezerah, maybe he'll come to eat from it. So you see that Rabbi Yehuda doesn't make a gezerah. How come when he's checking for the chametz, Rabbi Yehuda makes a gezerah, I'll come to eat from it? And over here by the omer, he doesn't make such a gezerah. Amar Rava says, Shani Hadash. Hadash is different. It's probably Rabba. It's probably changing. Well, yeah, but they had to get it ready from before Yom Tov.
Only to get it ready.
While you're working with it, you might come to eat from it. Says Gemara, Amar Ba, Shani Hadash, Mitoch Shelo Hitarta Lo, Ela Al Yedeh Ketuf, Hu Zachur. Rashi. Rabbi Yehuda Omer, Mitoch Shelo Hitarta Lo Ketzira Kederech Kol HaShana. When it comes to the Hadash, you don't let them cut it. Normally when you want to cut, you have a special knife, a sickle they call it, and you chop the wheat. But when it comes to Hadash that you're cutting before the Omer, you're not allowed. It's a Ba'asurim Milchsor Milifnei Omer. You're not allowed to cut any of the Hameshet Mine Dagan before the Omer. Why? Ela B'yadayim Kotvim HaMelilot. They pick off the berries min hakarka, or they pick off the, what's it called? They pick the stalks from the ground. The Ha'asur Lichsor Lifnei Omer. One of the Yisurim, it's an Yisur Doraita, is not to chop any of the wheat before the Omer. Dichtiv, like it says, Omer Reshit Ketzirechem El HaKohen. Reshit Ketzirechem, the first cutting. First cutting. So that means before you cut the Omer, now let it cut. It's a lava b'michla laseh. Right? Shehu Techila Lektira. So therefore, so if I want to get wheat out of the ground, even though it's asur to eat, how do I get around? I have to rip it out. That's kituf. No scissors, Jack. Right? Mitoch reshit kitzirichem shu techila lekitzira zachuru et isura hadash al yedei shinuya ma'ase v'lo ati lemechal. He's not going to come to eat. So that's his heter. Says because you make the guy cut it, you make the guy rip it. So there's a heker. He's not going to come to you. Says Gemara, Amar le'abaye teinach b'shat ketifa. So when you're cutting it, yeah, there's a difference. Techina v'harkada ma'ika le'meima. What are you going to do with the grinding? What are you going to do with the sifting?
What's the problem with that?
How are you not making a shinui there? You're missing the point. The question is, Rabbi Yehuda, when it came to Bi'ur Hametz, he didn't let you check after Sha'at Bi'ur. Why? He says, I'm afraid you're going to come to eat from it. He says, if you're afraid he's going to come to eat from the Hametz, why are you afraid he's going to eat from the Omer, from the Hadash? He says, no, the Hadash, when he cuts it, he makes a shinui. He says, very nice. When you cut it, you make a shinui. After that, Ba'aden. Right? He says, Gemara halo kashya. It's not difficult. Tehina berechaya diyad, harkada al gabe nafa. You're right. Every single step we have a shinui. Tehina, they use a rechaim shel mayim. You have to use a rechaim shel yad. Harkada, they sift it regular. You sift it upside down. Everything with a shinui. Ela had the tana. Look in the sheet. Tehina varkada share kemach tanena. It says they found Yerushalayim shehem meleim kemach. Somebody ground it. Tehaya biyadam uchshetahanu virkidu. When they grounded it, ez shinui hayasham. What shinui was them? Dololeti lemeitav lepu me'ayishata. Shanina we answer. Tehina lo ayu tohanim oto berechaim shel mayim. They didn't do it with a rechaim shel mayim. Ela berechaim shel yad. They did it with a rechaim shel yad. To have a shinui lezikaron, which is a shinui. Al gaben afa letzad tachton shel napa hopecha napa al piha al paneha. Okay. Ela hadetnan. We have another mishnah. Kotzrin betashalchin veshebaamakim avalogotchim. Rashi. Ela hadetnan b'minachot. Kotzrin betashalchin kederechol kodem laomer. A betashalchin is a certain type of field that they, what's it called? Beta Shalhin, it's an irrigated field. Veshel Beta Amakim, or the depths, it's a deep valley. Tevoa Gedela Ben Amakim. Beta Amma Mefaresh Hatam. The Gemara explains over there why you're allowed to cut it. Doesn't it say Reshit Ketzirechem? Katuv Echad Omer Uktzartem Et Ketzira Vahavetem Et Omer. Right? Uktzartem Et Ketzira. You cut before Vahavetem and then you bring. V'katuv echad omer, and another pasuk says, Alma mutar leksor kodem la'omer. V'katuv echad omer, omer reshit ketzirechem, that the first thing that you're going to cut is going to be the omer. V'mash mash hu kodem l'kol katzir. Ha keitzad, how does it work? Mimakom sh'ata mevi omer, iata kotzer. From a place that you can bring the omer, you can't cut. אתה קוצר קודם לו. You can't come before the Omer. וממקום שאתה מביא Omer, and from a place that you can't bring the Omer, אתה קוצר, you let it cut. ותנא בפרק כל הקורבנות, אין מביאים סולת למנחה. You don't bring סולת for the מנחה, לא מבית הזבלין, ולא מבית השלחין. You can't bring it from a field that needs to be fertilized. ולא מבית השלחין that needs to be irrigated. מפני שתבואה שלהן אינה מן המובחר. It's not the best type of תבואה. Since that's not the places that you're going to go to cut the Omer, therefore, it's not asur to cut the tevua there. That's legabe, that's the limud legabe, the isur of cutting before the omen. What does it have to do for us? Ma'ika lemeiman. So now I'm letting you cut kidarko. You told me that the reason why the biuda is not afraid that I'm going to come to eat from the hadash because you're doing it bishinui. So, but over here, the Mishnah says that they could cut in the regular way. Again, Ela Haditnan. Kotrim beta shalchim vishiba amakim. Avalogochim, but you can't pile it up. Veukimna kerbiuda, and we said like Rebiuda, my ikale meimar. What's the difference? What are you going to say? Why does he let you cut regular? Amarabaye. Amar Abai El. So therefore, how are you going to answer? Look at Rashi. Ma'ika lemema haleka hatam shinuya. Ta'a kotrim katani. They cut it regular ube magal with a regular sickle. V'lo gazrin until ma'ati lemechal. What is going to leave? Ukim la lehik and Rabbi Yehuda. And the Gemara and Masechet Menachot says it goes like Rabbi Yehuda. Beperek Rabbi Yishmael mi de katani seifa anshei yiricho kotrim lefnei omer. ולא מיחו בידם חכמים. ואמרים, אמן שם ידלד אמר מיחו ולא מיחו רבי יהודה. פיין, זה גמרא, זה זה רק רבי יהודה. And yet, it's not a שינוי. אלא, אביי says, I don't like your answer, אבא. אמר אביי, חדש בדיל מיני. חמץ לא בדיל מיני. חדש. It's been אסור until now. So it's on his mind.
That's
what a shinui for. Not a shinui. Look at Rashi. Hadash mivdal bedili mine. Sharei lo hurgalu. They're not in the habit lo ochlo kol hashana, to eat it all year. Ve'en lemudim lefshot yad lo shit lepihem. They don't put out their hand, stick it in their mouth. Aval hametz lemudim min bekach kol hashana. The whole year you're standing by the table, there's a cooking. If you're involved in Yasha and Hadash, you put a geder lefiha. Kanareh, when they work in the fields, they normally what's good, but they have this paha before by Hadash. It's not like they never worked in the field.
Orange stamp on the bread after Pesach.
Right?
You see, the good is not ready to eat yet? That's why.
No, not because of that. Because they know it's Asur. It's Asur until the Omer. So, Bedili mine. They're careful from it. Derbiuda, lo Bedili mine. Amar Rava commented. Derbiuda, Kasha. You only have a question. Derbiuda. Why over there he says it's Asur? He says Mutar. Derbanan, lo Kasha. You have the same question between the Chachamim and the Chachamim. How come over here the Chachamim make a gezerah that you might come to eat from it by the Hadash, and by the Chametz they don't make a gezerah, they let you check even a Hazman Isuro. Says the Gemara, Ela, Derbiuda, Adribiuda lo kashya kedishanina. Like we answered, because Hadash bedilimine. Drabanana, Amilo Kasha. You know why by Biur Hametz he lets you check for it even after his money surah and he's not going to say you might come to eat from it. Who atzmo mehazer alav lesurfo mechal ka'achil mina? You're right. Yesterday he wasn't badil mina. But what's he doing now? He's looking for it to burn it. Says that in itself makes a shinui in his head that he's not going to come to eat it from it. Rashi. Drabanana, drabanan lo kasha bitmiha. You're only answering Rabbi Yehuda. The Hadar Banan Nami Kashya. The Chachamim is also a question. The Bimadnitin Logazrina. And in the Mishnah, they didn't make a Gezerah. The Hatam Katani Shelo Birzon Chachamim. The Mashma de Gazar Bimir. do me b'nei pluta, b'nei pluta, d'oma ati l'meichel, maybe he'll come to eat. Who atzmo mechazer alav l'sorfo, avogav de'be'al magazrinan, even though normally we make a gezerah. Bedavar she'osek, she'asuk bo, something that he's working with. She'lo yoshit l'piv, he shouldn't put it in his mouth. Hacha. בבדיקת חמץ, לקה למגזר, אינו גזרה. והוא עצמו, כל עסקו זה בחמץ, אינו אלא מחזר עליו לסורפו. אין לך זיכרון לאיסור גדול מזה. There's no greater remembrance of איסור. ומייך על כך, ימיני בתמיהה. That's רב אז answered. רב אשי אמר, רב אשי says, דרביודה לוקשיה. It's not a question. Kemach ve'kalitinan. It's only kemach and kali. Those things you can't eat. Rashi. Kemach ve'kalitinan ve'en elu re'uyim la'achila. Says Gemara ve'had Rav Ashi bedutai. Rav Ashi's tirutz is a joke. Doesn't make sense. Rashi. Oh, Rashi. Okay. Says Gemara, why? Why is it a joke? Hateinach mikali va'elach. After it became roasted and it's dry and it's unedible, you're right, he can't eat it. Mi'ikara ad kali ma'ika lememah, from when the guy went into the field to cut it till he roasted it. Why didn't he eat it then? V'chi teima, what are you going to say? Al yede kituf kidraba, that it's talking that you cut, that you're ripping it out. So there's a shinui. Like Rava, and then you're going to sift it backwards and you're going to grind it with a haim shel yad. Very nice. Ela kotrim beta shalhin v'sheba amakim v'ukim nakir b'yudah ma'ika l'meimah. Hare, we said that there's certain types of field you're allowed to cut regularly. What are you going to say? There's no shinui. Ela, so like we said before, had ela Rav Ashi bedutai. Rav Ashi's answer is a joke, it doesn't work. Whenever they're not badil from it, does Rabbi Yehuda make a gizra? The hatinan. The hatinan. We learned the new mishnah. Kol lo yikov adam shefoferet shel betza. You're not allowed to make a hole in the shell of an egg. V'yimale en hashem and fill it up with oil. V'yitenena al pi aner and put it on the top of the ner. V'shvil shetehem en hatevet so it should drip in. V'afidu yishem heres. Even if you make it from clay, it's also asur. V'rib yuda matir, Rabbi Yehuda's matir. So you see, the chachamim make a gezera. Maybe you're going to come to take oil from this betza. And you can be chayav for mechabeh. And Rabbi Yehuda doesn't make a gezera because he says, badil mine. Gemara hata mishum humra de Shabbat mivdal bedili. Everybody's scared of Shabbat, so therefore they're not going to take from it. Look at Rashi. Menatefet tipin. Before that, Rashi says, kol ner shel gemara haynu akili krusil. That's the lamp that they light in. Menatefet tipin dakot. Little drips come in kishapetila mavheret. As the wick burns, it's dripping into it. That little shell, the meisa, so it's cheres, it gets black. It's still asud. Maybe you'll come to take some of the oil from it. V'tana, and we learned, hanoten shemen laner. If you put oil in the ner, chayav mishum avir. It's considered as if you burnt it. V'mistapek mimen. If you take oil out of it, chayav mishum mechabem. V'Rabbi Yehuda matir. Vavogav de shemen. Hakol tedirimbo. Everybody's used to it. People take all the time. So how come you don't make a gezera? Vidrabanana, drabanan lekala akshuya. We don't have a question between the chachamim. The haukim na ta'ama behametz. Hametz is different. The reason why they're not gozer in Yishum du atzmo mechazer ala l'sorfo, he's going to burn it. So that's why they'll make a gezera on Shabbat and not on hametz. But why does it be Yehuda not make a gezerah by Shabbat? So we answer, no. Chumrah de Shabbat, he's mivdal bedili minin. Virami de Shabbat a Shabbat. Let's ask a stira between Rabbi Yehuda's gezerot and Shabbat. The Tanya we learned, hevel dli, shenifsak, if you have the string that they use, that they attach to the pail, to draw water from the well. Shinifsak, it broke on Shabbat, you can't get water. Lo yehe koshro, don't tie the string back together. Ela onvo, make a bow. Rabbi Yudah, Omer Rabbi Yudah says, korech alav pundia o piskia. Tie the string with a punda, with a belt. Ubilvad shelo ya'anvenu, but don't make a bow knot. So Rashi says, let's see Rashi. Koshnin dli bepiskia. Oh, sorry, wrong one. Lo ye koshno dehave kesher shel kayama. If you retie the rope, it's a kesher, a permanent knot. Ela unvo, make a bow, make a loop knot. Velo gazrinan aniva atu keshira. We don't make a gezerah that if I let you make aniva, you're going to come to make keshira. Rabbi Yudah says, korech kericha be'alma. Just wrap it with a punda, ezur halul, or piskiya, fishliya, shekorchim, sivivot shokayim. Bilvad shelo ya'anvenu, gezira mishum keshira. Because he makes a gezira. If I let you tie it, you might come, if I let you loop it, you might come to tie it. So he says, instead, use a belt. Kashya drabiyudah, kashya drabanan, drabanan. Over there, the chachami make a gezira, keshira. They don't make a gezira aniva atu keshira. And Rabbi Yudah makes it over here. Adraba, Rabbi Yudah. Sorry. And Mashen came by the ner. The Chachamim made the gezira, and Rabbi Yudah didn't. Says the Gemara. Lo kashi. Drabanan, lo kashi. It's not a question between the Chachamim and Rabbi Yudah. Shemen be shemen michlaf. Aniva be keshira lo michlaf. What are you saying? That he's going to take oil from here or take oil from someplace else? He'll get mixed up. Aniva b'kishira is two separate things. One is a loop, one is a knot. He's not going to get mixed up. Derbiuda lo kasha. Tama derbiuda la mishum de gazar aniva atu kishira. He's not making a gezera that if I make a bow, I'm going to come to make a knot. I don't make a gezera by the shemen. And I don't make a gezerah by the what's it called? I don't make a gezerah by the oil. Ela mishum de kasavar aniva gufa kishirahi. That's the mahloka. We mentioned it before. Rabbi Yudah holds making a bow is kosher. It's not nothing less than that. Rashi. Rashi shemen ze b'shemen de kol hashana michli v'ati lemichle. The Gemara asks another question. V'rami drabanan adrabanan. I'm going to ask a stira between the chachamim. The tanan koshnim dli b'piskia. If you have a dli, if you have a pail, you're allowed to tie a bepiskia with a belt, avalo behevel, but not with a string. Why? Because if I use a piskia, right? If I use a belt, it's not a problem. You're not going to leave it there. You're going to take it off. Avalo behevel, but not with a string, because you're going to leave it there. L'chaura, it's a permanent knot. Rabbi Yudah matir. Rabbi Yudah says you're allowed to tie the knot. You're allowed to tie the hevel. Says Gemara, hevel demai. What kind of string is it? Ilay mehevel de alma. If it's a regular string, Rabbi Yudah matir, he lets you make a knot. Kesher shel kayamah, it's a permanent knot. Devadai ati leftula. Of course, you're going to leave it there. It's a regular rope. You have it tied onto the dli. Why wouldn't you leave it there? Ela pshita degardi. The rope that you're using is a specialized rope. It's a weaver rope. So you would never leave it there permanently. So that's why Rabbi Yudah says, I allow you to tie it with a weaver rope. What am I afraid of? If you're going to leave it there, you got to be crazy to leave it there. So imagine you tied it with an extension cord. You're going to leave the extension cord there. You're going to change it. Because why would I waste an extension cord on a pail? So too, a hevel de gardi is expensive. I'll use it in a pinch, maybe, but I'm not going to leave it there. So Rabbi Yudah says, tie with it. You're not going to come to leave it there. Right? And why don't the chachamim cheat the gardi? The Chachamim make a gezerah. They say you're right. he's not going to leave this rope there. But if I let this guy tie with the Gardi rope, the next guy is going to tie with the regular rope. Right? Atu Hevel de Alma. No. If he ties it with a regular rope, it's a Nisu de Oraita.
Oh, okay.
The Tanat, right? Again, Virami Drabanan Drabanan. The Tanat Koshnim Dalib over here. We said that the Chachamim don't make a Gezerah Aniva Atu Keshira. Right? They say if you make a loop, you're not going to come to make a permanent knot. Yeah, when it comes to the Hevel, they say Koshnim Dalib Bepiskiya. He could tie with a piskia, avalo behevel. And we say, what type of hevel is that? A hevel de gardi. Even though that's also not a permanent knot. Why? Gizirah, if you use a hevel de gardi, you're going to come to use a hevel de alma. How come they didn't make a gizirah keshira atu aniva? Aniva atu keshira. Says the Gemara, the gazir of hevel de gardi al hevel de alma. In, yeah, it's no problem. Hevel behevel michlaf. People will make a mistake between one type of rope and another type of rope. But aniva bekeshira lo michlifa. Nobody's going to change aniva and keshira. Everybody knows one is a knot, one is not.
They know, sure.
Vekol heched de badil mine lo gazrinan. So now. Let's see, just see Rashi before. Chevel bechevel michlaf. Vehashta itar tzukulu. All the Mishnayot and the Braitot are good. The Rabbanan gazru kol eichad de michlaf. Wherever they feel that you can get mixed up, they make a gezerah, bim b'shabah, bim b'sha'ar, isure. Whoever it is. Hilkach bechadash lefnei ha'omer gazru, you might come to eat. Vechem b'shefuferit, you might come to take oil. Vechem bechevel, chevel de gardiyatu, chevel de alma. Aval behametz lo, they don't make it asur to check for the hametz after by shat biur mishum de muzhar alav lesorfo, because he himself mehader alav lesorfo, he's running to get burn it, he's not going to eat it. Ube aniva nami lo mishum de lo mechlefa, they don't think it's something that you get mixed up. Rabbi Yehuda gazar bekol midi de lo bedili mina, anything that people don't stay away from, like hametz. Something they stay away from, like chadash lo gazar. Hilkach behametz gazar al behadash bedili mine. Ubekol hanach, and then the rest of them, the Shabbat mishum de bedili mine, because people stay away from it, like the shemen, he's not gozer. Utka machmir ba'aniva. Why does he say you can't loop it? Not because he makes a gezera aniva atu keshira. Now the Gemara continues. Wherever a person stays away from something, Rabbi Yehuda doesn't make a gezerah. Vehatanya, we learned, bechor, you have a bechor, so it's a korban, it's kadosh. She'achazot dam. And now it gets too much blood. So the refuah is to let some blood out. Right now. A bechor is a korban. You're not allowed to make a mum in the kodashim. But the only way to save the behemah's life is to make a cut. So what should you do? Bechor she'ahazodam. Rashi, bechor asur la'atil bo mum. Va'afil legrom, even to cause a mum is asur. Kedetanya mum lo yeh bo. Not lo ta'aseh bo, lo yeh bo. Enli ela שלא יטיל בו מום, מנה שתאמרו לו הכל מום במסכת ביצה. אין מקיזין דם, אפילו במקום שאין עושה בו מום. Even if you make the cut in a place where it's not going to make a מום. דהיינו בכל מקום שבו, any place on it, אם אינו חותך ממנו עצם, if you're not cutting off a limb, או פוגם שפתו, או you're blemishing its lip, or it's not its ear. וכל דבר שאינו חוזר כדמותו, anything that doesn't go back to normal, have a מום. Idach, other things, lo have a mum. The kagazar Rabbi Yehuda atu makom she'ose bo mum. He makes it. Rabbi Yehuda says, afilu hu lasi. Vatanya, bechor she'ahazot dam, afilu hu met. En mekizim dam. Don't take any blood. So Rashi says, back in that Rashi, bottom line, the kagazar Rabbi Yehuda atu makom she'ose bo mum. He says, don't make a mum where it doesn't make a mum, because you're going to come to make a cut where it does make a mum. ואף אגב דקדשים הכל בדילים מהם, even though everybody's careful with קדשים. מחלוק רבי דוד רבי שמעון בתורת כהנים. והחכמים אומרים, יקיז, you could make it. ומלבד שלא יטיל בו מום. So why does Rabbi Yehuda make a gezira? Hatam over there is different. Mitoch she'adam bahul al mamono, he's nervous. Kohen ze bahul al habechor shelo yamut, he doesn't want it to die. Amrina, we say when he's nervous, isharid le b'makom she'eno sim bo mum. If you allow him to make the cut where it doesn't make a mum, ati le me'ebad b'makom she'eno sim bo mum, he's going to come to make the cut where it does make a mum. So that's why the Rabbi Yehuda says, don't let him do anything.
What? If it's not yeah, the person, you can trust him.
Ati le, but a banan. Opposite. Kol sheken. De'iloshari le'klal ati le'me'bar. If you don't allow him anything, he's just going to do anything. If you tell him, control yourself, good. Rashi kol sheken. Ho'il ba'hul hu, since he's very nervous. De'iloshari le'be'makom she'en oseh b'mum over al devarecha. He's not going to listen. Ve'oseh. And now, v'shuv enu nizar. The rabbi says everything is asur. En nizar be'makom le'mum le'shelo b'mkom mum. De'savur sha'kol shavi. He's going to think it's all the same. Do we say according to the Biuda when a person is nervous about his money that we have to be gozer? Now we learn the Biuda Omer en mekaredina behema biyom tov. You now let it comb the animal on yom tov. Bepeneshu oseh haburakos is going to make a blemish, and he's going to take out blood, and it's like mekiz on yom tov. It's like a nitilat neshama. Aval mikartzefim. Another type of combing is mutar. V'chachamim omrim en mikadirim, af en mikartzefim. V'tanya we learned, ezeo kidur ve'ezeo kirtzuf. What kidur and what kirtzuf? Kidur, ketanim, is smaller holes in the comb. Ve'osim habura. They wind up making a habura. Kirtzuf, yedolim, is big holes. Ve'en osim habura, they don't make a habura. So, you see that Rabbi Yehuda, he allows you to use the bigger comb, and he doesn't make a gezerah since you're bahul. Now, look in Rashi, he explains a little bit. Mekaderim istralin is a combing. Mekartzefin kedeprishina, like we explained, bechlig sheshinav gasot, with a keli that has big teeth. Ve'enu oseh habura. It doesn't make a habura. Dehobel beba'ale hayim av melacha. If you make a blemish, it's an av melacha. Katani miyata val mekartzefim. Alma lo gazar. He doesn't make a gezerah. Mitoch she'adam ba'ol, because he's nervous. Isharit le kirtzuf. If you allow him to make the big one, abid kidur, he's going to do the other one. Why would he do it? And why is he nervous? But if your animal is not looking so ay-ay-ay on Yom Tov, a guy gets nervous. Oh, I can't eat. My animal, his hair is messy. So Rashi says, Lefi shatit machish et beima. What's he combing? There's mud in the fur, in the wool. And it bothers the animal. It's like it pulls or something, right? So you comb it to get it out. So he'll be nervous. His animal is suffering. He gets weak. Says the Gemara. So you're telling me, see, he's nervous about the Bechor Sha'achazodam. So the Biuda says, don't let him do anything. Over here also he's nervous. His animal is in pain. It needs to be calmed out. Why is the Biuda allowed to use the big comb? He should make a Gezerah. Don't do anything. Because you might come to use the small comb.
He's not losing anything.
What?
He's not losing anything. Over there, he might lose the animal.
The animal's inside. It's not going to eat good. It's going to get weak. It's not going to be so fat. It's not going to sell for so much money. If he doesn't find the small, big comb, he'll use the small comb. I know, he's nervous. When you're nervous, you do everything wrong. Says the Gemara, Hatam, by the Bechor Sha'ahazodam, the Ishavik le Mayit, if you leave it, it dies. Amrina Nadam Bahul Al Mamono, person is nervous. Hacha, Ishavik le, if you leave it, Sa'ara be Al Mahul. It's just mother. Lo Amrina Nadam Bahul Al Mamono. You don't say he's so nervous. But Rabbi Yehuda, מה ישנה גבי חמץ לגזר, ומה ישנה גבי קרצוף ללא גזר? How come by the חמץ he makes a גזירה that you shouldn't check? ומה ישנה גבי קרצוף ללא גזר, he doesn't make it. גמרא לחם בלחם מחלף. One bread, the other bread, he makes, you can get mixed up. חמץ and מצה, it's both, they both look like פיתות. Kidur bekirtzuf lo mikhlaf, the combs are very different. With the chachamim, all the person will get mixed up. Nu mishnah, Rabbi Meir omer, Rabbi Meir says, ochlim kol hamesh, you're allowed to eat chametz during the fifth hour of the day, till an hour before hatzot. Vesorfim, and we burn it betchilat shesh, in the beginning of the sixth hour, look at Rashi. Vaaf agav dekol sha'ash ishit midoraita sharia, even though the whole sixth hour, right, the sixth hour is the hour that leads till Hatzot. And we said, ach, midoraita, hametz becomes asur after Hatzot. The chachamim make a gezerah del matai. Maybe he's going to come to make a mistake.
The sixth hour
is like, let's imagine that if sunrise is at 6 and sunset is at 6, right? So the sixth hour is like from 11 to 12. 1 hour before Hatzot, right? The first hour is from 6 to 7. The second hour is 7 to 8. The third hour, 8 to 9. The fourth hour, 9 to 10. The fifth hour is 10 to 11. The sixth hour is 11 to 12. Right? So technically the Hametz doesn't become Asur until 12. But Rabbi Meir says, the guy might make a mistake. In those days, they didn't have a clock. First of all, this clock could be off. But besides that, they didn't have the, you looked at the sun. Yeah, make a mistake. They saw our film. You're with us. In the Mishnah over there.
Always with
you. No, over here. Right? Vesorfim b'tchilat shesh. The Bimi says you have to burn the chametz in the beginning of the sixth hour. Ve'avagav dekol sha'ashishim midoraita sharia. Even though the whole sixth hour midoraita, it's mutar. Gazur rabbanan ala. The chachamim made a gezira. Dil matai. Maybe he's going to make a mistake. Ve'savur ala shevi'it shushishit. He'll think about the seventh hour that it's the sixth hour. Aval ha'chamishit lo ta'i. On the fifth hour, he won't make a mistake. Lomar ala shivichu hamishit mutar. That's too far of a mistake. Okay. Rabbi Yehuda Omer, Rabbi Yehuda says, Ochlim kol arba. You're only allowed to eat till the end of the fourth hour. Vitolim kol hamesh. The fifth hour, you leave this stuff. We'll see. Vesorfim, and you burn a bit chilat shesh in the beginning of the sixth hour. So what Rabbi Meir said, Ochlim kol hamesh, from 10 to 11, you're allowed to eat. Rabbi Yehuda says, no, from 10 to 11, you don't eat, but you don't have to burn. In the sixth hour, you burn. Rashi. Tolim kol hamesh. Eno ochel, don't eat it. Deta'eh, he might even make a mistake from 12 to 10. V'savar al shivi'it, shi hamishi. He'll think about the seventh hour of the day, which is from 12 to 1. That it's still 10 o'clock.
What's the problem with burning?
Burn whenever you want. You don't have to burn yet. Umiu lisrof eno tzarich. He doesn't have to burn. And therefore, ma'ach, meaning it's mutar bahana'ah. Uma'achilo lebehemto. You can't eat it, but you can feed your animals. Aval shishi, in the sixth hour, af bahana'ah asur. Midra banan, gezerah mishum shivid. You might come to Havana in the seventh hour. ועוד אמר רבי יהודה, רבי יהודה said more, שתי חלות של תודה פסולות. There were two חלות תודה, Rashi. Now, חלות תודה של חמץ. In the תודה, there's four types of bread. Three types of matzah, and one type is חמץ. Right? So they took the חלות that were חמץ. של תודה פסולות, ובגמרא מפרש, בגמרא כתובה, מי פסולין הוא? How did they become פסול? מונחות על גב האצטבה. Every Erev Pesach, they would put these two loaves up on like a platform. Kol zman shemunahot, as long as they were there, everybody would look up at the Beit HaMikdash. They saw these two loaves. Fadal, eat. Kol ha'am ochlim, everybody ate. Nitla ahat, when they took one away, tolin, they stopped eating, but they would still feed the animals. Lo ochlim, they didn't eat, ve lo sorfim, but they didn't burn. litnu shetehem, when they took both away, hitchilu kol ha'am sorfim, everybody started burning. Rabban Gamliel omer, Rashi, nitlachat mehem betchilat chamesh, ba shaliach bedim v'natal ahad. One of the representatives from bedim will come and take one away. So you see the proof to me. According to the Bimeir, there's no middle ground. There's either eat or burn. So what do you need two halof for? Put one, take one away. Whereas according to the Biuda, there's eat until the end of the fourth hour. The fifth hour, you do nothing. You can feed to the Be'eman. The sixth hour, you burn. That's why I need two. So from the fact that they had such a system, Biuda says, you see, I'm right, you're wrong. Rabban Gamliel Omer, he has like a different compromise. Holy, where there's no Isur to burn it. Ne'echalim kol arba. You eat the fourth hour, and the fourth hour, stop eating it. V'truma kol hamesh. But teruma, you can eat even in the fifth hour. We make a gezerah on holin because it's balash. It doesn't cost me anything. But teruma, then there's an isur of burning it for no reason. We let you eat for the extra hour. V'sorfim b'tchilat shesh, and you burn in the beginning of the sixth, the holin and the teruma. Look at Rashi. Teruma kol hamesh, de'asu lafsid kadashim b'yadayim kol zman she'achol ochlam. Why is it? The Chachamim, when they made the extra gezerav, the extra hour, they didn't want to put it on terumah because it might cause you to burn extra terumah that doesn't have to be burnt. Vesorfim b'tchilat shesh, the havadai ruba tau ben shesh l'sheva. And the mistake between 6 and 7 is very common. Now we're going to make even on terumah. The mistake between 5 and 7, it's a little bit more dahuk. For hulim, we'll make it. For terumah, we don't make it. Now the Gemara is going to have, the truth is this sugya is going to end only over here. Maybe even further. But I'll call panim, the Gemara is going to start discussing mistakes, how people make a mistake in time. Tenan hatam, we have a Mishnah over there in Masechet Sanhedrin. When two people are coming and they're testifying about something that happened, but they're giving different times. So say ehad omer bishnayim bahodesh ve'ehad omer bishlosha. One guy says he killed him on the 2nd of the month. The other guy says he killed him on the 3rd of the month. Now on the surface, those two guys are clearly mixed up. Right? They're not saying the same thing. Edutan kayemet. The edut is kayam. Why? Because they're really saying the same thing. Sheze yodea bi'iburo shel chodesh v'zeinu yodea. The guy that says it was on the 2nd, he knows that month, they made it 30 days the month before. So the Rosh Chodesh wasn't on Monday, Rosh Chodesh was on Tuesday. Whereas the first guy, he thinks Rosh Chodesh was on Monday. Easy mistake to make. Echad omer b'shlosha ve'echad omer b'hamisha. But one guy says 3, one guy says 5. There ain't no mistake in the world that could get those 2 days to be the same. They're clearly off by a day. Edutam betela. The edut is batel.
If it's the same time, let's say, during the day, the exact details, except the date.
What?
If they get the exact details, what time during the day and everything.
Yeah, but they're saying different dates of the month.
Doesn't mean the guy, didn't kill him. Maybe he...
They're not saying the same. But one guy says he killed him on Tuesday. One guy says he killed him on Wednesday.
If they ask him after a long time.
Okay. I killed him on Tuesday, killed him on Wednesday. They're not saying the same thing. I need two edim saying the same thing. They're not saying the same thing. Look in Rashi. Echad omer b'shnayim b'chodesh on the 2nd of the month. Harag ze'et ha'nefesh. This guy killed someone. Ve'echa min ha'edim omer b'shlosha b'chodesh. Edutam kayemet. Ubedin ayu botkim otam b'sheva hakirot. Bedin had to inspect them. Had to ask them 7 questions, mandatory questions. Kedil kaman. Like we're going to say later. Ve'kivan d'hushvu shenehem. Lomar b'shlishi obervi'i. They both said that it was on Tuesday or Wednesday.
Tuesday or the 3rd day of the month?
Tuesday or Wednesday. Ukhshibat kumem, when we asked them, Ezi yom bechodesh, which day of the month was it? Amar ze besheni veze amar beshlishi. This guy said it was the 2nd, this guy said it's the 3rd. Shenehem al yom ehad ha'idu. They're both testifying about the same day. Ela sheze yada b'iburo shel chodesh. This guy knew that the month was a leap month. Shechodesh avar male v'ugbar rosh chodesh b'yom ha'shloshim. They made rosh chodesh on the 30th of the month. Ve'echad, ve'shloshim ve'echad, meaning rosh chodesh. They were 30 days in the month before. V'ukbar Rosh Chodesh, Rosh Chodesh of the next month was on the 31st day. V'zeh she'amar b'shnayim b'chodesh, the one that said it was on the second of the month, Yadabo, he knew that. V'zeh she'amar shilosha, the guy that said it's the third of the month. Savur, he thought she'ukbar chodesh b'yom shiloshim.
He didn't go to shul that week.
Right? So he thought that Rosh Chodesh was on the on the 30th day.
So if they say the day of the month, if they say the day of the week, well, the first thing?
Of course not. Well, he thought Shabbat was on Friday?
That's what I said.
Since people make mistakes, even though there's a mitzvah to try and break up the edut, כדי להציל על את הנפש in order to save, like it says, והצילו העדה, אין בידינו כוח לחלקו. We don't have the power to divide it because they're just making this mistake. But if they say 3 and 5, עדותם בטלה. תבהלק על המתעד, there's no mistake. וקרא כתיב ודרשת וחקרת, you have to investigate and make חקירות. והנה אמת נכון, שתהה עדותן מכוונת, the עדות has to go together. If the edut is not unified, lo katlinan, v'hu v'hem peturin, everybody's patur. The en edim neheragim al yedei el yedei hazama. The edim can't be killed unless you make hazama. This is not hazama. This is just a bad edut. So that's when it comes to days of the month. Echad omer b'shtei sha'ot. One guy says he killed him in the second hour of the day. Which is what? It's from 7 to 8. From 8 to 9, edutan kayemet, the edut is kayam. Echad omer b'shalosh, ve'echad omer b'chamesh. One guy said it was in the third hour, from 8 to 9. One guy said it was in the fifth hour, from 10 to 11. No, from 11. From 10 to 11. One says it's from in the third hour.
8 to 9.
One guy said it's 10 to 11, right? 2 hours apart. Edutam betela, the edut is batel. Devre Rabbi Meir. That's Rabbi Meir's opinion. Rabbi Yehuda says no. If one guy says 8 to 9, one guy says 10 to 11, the edut is still kayam. Edutam kayamet. Echad omer b'chamesh, v'echad omer b'sheva, but Rabbi Yehuda agrees. If one says in 5 and one says in the 7th hour, edutam betela, the edut is batel. Why? Shebe Hamesh, in the fifth hour, Hama b'Mizrach, the sun is still on the east side of the sky. U'b'Shiv'a, in the seventh hour, Hama b'Ma'arav, the sun already moved to the other side. You can't make such a mistake. You can make a mistake if the sun is lower or higher. It's how high, how low. Okay. But to make a mistake, if it's on this side and that side, you don't make a mistake. Amar Abaye says, Kishetim Tzilu. So how do we understand the Machloket? What exactly are they arguing about? Kishetim tzil omar, when you're going to want to explain the Mishnah, you're going to say like this. L'divrei Rabbi Meir, en adam to'ev lo klum. People don't make mistakes in time. Rabbi Yehuda omer, and Rabbi Yehuda says, adam to'ev hatzi sha'a. Person can make a mistake of a half an hour. So watch. L'divrei Rabbi Meir, en adam to'ev lo klum. Ma'aseh ki hava. When did the guy kill him? B'mefak tarte u'me'ayil tlat. At the end of the second hour, the beginning of the third hour. Right? So one guy says it was the second hour. Yeah, it's the end of the second hour. The other guy says it's the third hour. Yeah, it's the beginning of the third hour. Besof Stein. V'had ka'amal shalosh betchilat shalosh. L'divrei Rabbi Yehuda, adam to'e hatzi sha'a. A person can make a mistake of a half hour. How is that? Ma'aseh ki hava bepalga de'arba. It was in the middle of the fourth hour. 9:30. The guy that said it was in the third hour, he meant it was the end of the third hour. He's making a mistake a half hour early. It was at 9:30, he thought it was at 9. Right? The guy that says it's in the fifth hour, בתחילת חמש. He means it's in the beginning. He means it's at 10 o'clock. וקטאי פלגה דשעתה לאחורי. He's delaying from 9:30 to 10. Half hour. But the most you're going to make a mistake is a half hour in time. That's one way Abaye explains it. Ike da Amri, others explain. Amar Abaye, we're on the bottom of Yud Aleph Amud Bet. We're explaining a machloket in the Mishnah between Rabbi Meir and Rabbi Yehuda. Rabbi Meir says that if two edim come, one ed says that he killed him in the third hour. One ed says he killed him in the fourth hour. The edut stands. Why? Because a person might make such a mistake between three and four. But one says three and one says five. Rabbi Meir says it's no good. Rabbi Yehuda says, no, even that's good. You can make a mistake between the third and the fifth hour. So right till now, Abaye said, Rabbi Meir says a person doesn't make any mistake. And Rabbi Yehuda says you make a mistake half an hour. Now we're going to give another explanation. Ika de Amri, Amar Abaye, kishetim tzelomar, when you're going to want to say, ledevre Rabbi Meir adam to'emashu, a person can make a small amount of mistake, 10, 15 minutes. Ledevre Rabbi Yehuda adam to'esha'au mashu. Person makes a mistake of a little bit more than an hour. How is that? Lidivre Rabbi Meir adam to'emashu ma'aseh ki hava. When did the murder take place? O besof shtayim have o betchilat shalosh. Either the end of two or the beginning of the third. V'had minayu to'emashu. One guy's making a little bit of mistake. A couple of minutes.
Where's the hour emashu over here?
Well, no, that's the next guy. That's Rabbi Yehuda. Rabbi Meimashu. It was at 8:45, which is in the. No, it was at 7:45, which is in the second hour. He's in the third hour. 15-minute mistake. Ma'aseh ki o b'sof shtayim o b'tchilat shalosh. So one guy, v'chad minayu, one of the two guys, toy mashu, he's making a mistake. 5-10 minutes, moving it to the different hour. Fine. L'divrei Rabbi Yehuda, adam toeh sha'ah mashu. Person can make a mistake of more than an hour. Ma'aseh ki hava. When did the story happen? O b'sof shalosh. Or b'tchilat chamesh, towards the end of the third hour, or the beginning of the fifth hour. So the guy that said the third hour is right, or the guy that said the fifth hour is right. V'had minayu, and the other guy katai sha'ah mashu. He's making a mistake of a little bit over an hour. That's the way Abaye said it.
You're talking about here only the obvious hours, which is three or four. You can make a mistake, but if it. First hour or second hour, I believe they don't give you 1 hour.
Why?
Which is sun. You can see if it's a sunny day or early in the morning, between 6 and 7, you see the difference.
Maybe. We'll see.
But the over here, 10 or 11, it doesn't
seem so much
but
like
they're holding only third or fourth hour. They're not talking about the first
you
hour.
You think those are the only complicated hours? And right after next, guy's not going to make a mistake.
That's maybe. What I said, yeah. The first hour, you can see the difference.
Maybe. We have.
It looks like you're holding the 3 hour.
We're going to come back to review this all tomorrow because we have a whole page of this mahlok. Baruch Adonai l'olam. Amen.